Does PRP treatment make sense at age 62? I have had two MicroPen treatments and have seen some mild improvements in fine lines and overall skin texture. Doctor has suggested adding PRP to ramp up the treatment. However, I have read that skin collagen is virtually non-existent by age 60. This is an expensive treatment, and I can't afford to waste any money. Would this be helpful or a waste of money?
Thank you for your question. You're 62 years old, and you're asking if it's possible to generate collagen after the age of 62, given that you've recently had two MicroPen treatments, and your doctor suggested PRP, and you want to know if it's possible for you to benefit, and you are concerned because of the expense of the treatment, whether or not it's worth it. Now, you did not submit any photos, so I can't give you any alternate options, but I can give you a sense of how I have this discussion with my patients who come to me in our practice. To begin with, I'm going to give you a little bit of background. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I've been a strong proponent of platelet-rich plasma, PRP, as well as in many arenas, including the treatment of skin quality, texture, wrinkles, under-eye dark circles, acne scars. I'm a very active member of the Vampire Facelift Network of doctors. I've also developed a hair loss solution called hair regeneration using platelet-rich plasma. So there really is no end to the benefits I see with PRP, and I use it a lot in my cosmetic procedures, whether they're with lasers or with my surgical procedures. So to answer the question, first you have to understand collagen is a protein, and it's an important protein, and yes, as we get older, we have less collagen. But the question is, can you induce collagen? And the answer is yes, you can. Now, what is the best way to induce collagen? Therein lies the very complicated part of this question. Your doctor is trying to do something for you which your doctor feels will be of value with microneedling. Now, certainly you've expressed that the cost is an issue, and it might be that your doctor chose these options because they were less expensive. You know, there is always this balancing act that we have to do with our patients every day, is trying to figure out how to get the best outcomes and work within a budget. In our practice, we treat everyone from people who have very low-paying jobs to people who run hedge funds or travel internationally and are very wealthy. Our offices are in very, very prestigious areas of Manhattan and Long Island. So certainly it is no doubt that if you have the resources, you have a lot of options. That being said, just to answer the question, can PRP help someone who's 62? The answer is yes, PRP can. How much it helps you, that's a different question. When I explain to patients how PRP works, what does it do? It is basically a concentration of the wound healing and growth factors necessary when you have a trauma, like a cut. By concentrating those growth factors and those cells, we're able to stimulate collagen. So what is often a strategy that I employ for older people, not necessarily 62 being older, but certainly there's a difference between 62 and 32. However, I will often combine PRP with hyaluronic acid because there is a very good synergy with hyaluronic acid and platelet-rich plasma, which has been shown in wound healing studies completely unrelated to aesthetics. So I think you need to have a good, close heart-to-heart with your doctor first, because your doctor is trying to solve the challenge of helping you but it might be that there are some limitations. We have, in our practice, solutions that go from non-surgical skincare products to injectables to regenerative medicine technology like PRP, as well as lasers, radiofrequency, and advanced cosmetic surgery. So there is a wide range of things we can offer our patients. And what we figure out with our patients every day is what defines success. And if something defines success that requires a lot more than the patient's ready to spend, then we try to figure out what defines reasonable success. Essentially, how can we make a person happy and at the same time work within a budget? If it can't be done, then it can't be done and we don't do it. But I think it's very important at this point for you to discuss this with your doctor. You, as long as you're alive, you can build collagen. Just like saying to someone, can you build muscle at 62? Yes, you can. You can do resistance training and build muscle. It's not the same as someone who's 22, but you can still do it. So it's very important to understand what kind of outcome will be satisfactory, because sometimes people can lose kind of focus on what ultimately defines success, and it's all about communication. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.